But Sanjeev, are there lessons to be learned from Mamata Banerjee? Because the one thing that Mamata has shown is that you can't just paratroop in and go out. You have to stay there, work with the people. That's how over a decade you create a mobilization that can bring down the mighty left empire. Is it a fair accusation that Rahul paratroops in, paratroops out, and then is not to be seen for very long?
Okay, just for the sake of introducing some variety. And so I'll be less of a cynic on that one. You know, what's the issue? I was discussing, actually doing a piece this morning, and the problem with Rahul Gandhi and the people when we try and analyze him is that if he plays politics like he did yesterday, we say, why is he playing politics? Why has he gone there? Why is he paratrooping coming out? Why did he spend 16 hours? The BJP leaders said, how come he was allowed? He was in collusion with Mayawati. Why didn't some of the BJP leaders put up some smart thinking hat and try to go in a mobike or do something smart? Why were they so obviously going to DND highway in Noida and getting caught, captured and coming back? So somebody is just trying to be a little innovative. Fine, there are a lot of problems with Rahul Gandhi, a lot of problems with the way he's approaching politics. And I completely agree that one should know more about him. But you know, this whole thing of damn you do this and damn you don't do this. If you're a politician, you should behave like an NGO. If you behave like an NGO, why are you in active politics? You should be doing some jholawala business. You know, the whole thing is that give the man his due. A person who could have become the prime minister 5 years ago, and everybody in this room and everybody in this country knows that, if he has not done that, if he's playing some backroom politics, trying to understand, trying to figure his way in or out of some kind of chakravyuh, whether he fails or succeeds, whose definitive opinion on worldview do we know in this country?
Okay.
whose definitive views on everything? You know, why do they expect all of that from this man?
Sanjeev, any prime minister 5 years ago, I'm not so sure about that. Rahul. But yes, we don't really know much about the guy, but about his views on a whole lot of things.
Has he handled his cards well?
Well, Ishan. Rahul, I think, you know, I mean, it's a good comparison, rather, sort of, it's a good case of contrast. Mamata Banerjee, Shingur, Nandigram happened because West Bengal and the whole region of Bengal has a long history of peasant protest, mobilization, and so on and so forth. And it's that particular legacy that was also manifest in Shingo. Mamata happened to be there to take over. Now, Rahul Gandhi, he goes to Udayagiri and say, I want to see this hill. I like this beautiful place. I have some links with Orissa. I mean, this is a woolly-headed, bleary-headed, okay, fine, like, you know, this is a beautiful country, the seas are blue. It doesn't really help. What does Rahul Gandhi understand about the Land Acquisition Act that's on in UP? This is an act that your government over the years has actually sort of, you know, taken it to a point where the person who loses land has absolutely no legal remedy except for saying that I want 50 rupees more as compensation, and if it's rejected, he loses the land. Now, I mean, there is also the suggestion that the Land Acquisition Act has to be changed. The suggestion that is really coming out, the outcome would be more draconian than what you have today, because land is not something of a commodity.
But in that sense, Siddharth, is it not more important for him to try and get this government to pass the land acquisition bill than to go and create this stuff? Because if he had a new, relevant, modern bill, it might ensure that some of what happened at Shingur, Nandigram and in Greater Noida might not actually take place.
Well, the bill is being fast-tracked, as we know now. Manmohan Singh has asked for this to be expedited. And I presume once Mamata wins, if she indeed wins, then this is going to happen. But I think Rahul Gandhi's politics has two components. For want of a better term, at the base, it operates at the base, it operates at the superstructure. What's he doing? He's doing at the level of the base, restructuring the way in which first the Youth Congress and then the Congress Party relates to its members. His grand vision, such as it is that party members do not get empowered by dint of being a member of a party. They're disconnected from politics. And if party members aren't empowered, what about ordinary citizens? So he's trying to reach, and I think he's trying to do something very healthy at the base of Indian politics, which every party perhaps ought to follow. However, he comes under pressure, and this is what I mean by superstructure, to intervene from the top. Go to Odisha, go to UP. These are the pressures coming from people who have anointed him India's next prime minister. And obviously then he has to play that role, he has to be involved in day-to-day issues, where I agree with everybody here that he is largely a misfit, not able to connect, not able to communicate effectively, and as Swapan says, even though we have some inkling of his general worldview, I would locate him quite firmly in the same area where his mother is, which is a, you know, social democratic kind of, but I don't think he is right now going into the depth of any issue, and I'm not sure that these interventions of his are all that worthwhile.
Because they're
for the
very
party.
Cosmetic, the interventions.
I mean, I,